Hello dear friends, today we are going to take a look at an unusual anti-tank grenade from Germany, which was used during the Second World War. This is the PanzerWurfMine 1L shaped charge hand thrown anti-tank grenade. This grenade was commissioned by the Luftwaffe in 1943 to arm paratroopers, but was later used extensively by the Wehrmacht. The droplet-shaped body of the grenade was made of metal. The grenade handle was made of wood, inserted into the hole in the body and fixed with screws. There was a spring-loaded stabilizer on the handle that consisted of four springs with a cloth attached to them. After the grenade is thrown, the safety cap stays in the hand and releases the springs, which then expand and tighten the stabilizer strips, giving the grenade a stable trajectory. The grenade was hidden on the soldier's belt, which was done with the help of a hole in the body of the grenade. During the storage and transportation, the grenade was carried in a pouch to protect it from water and dust. The grenade, weighing 1,400 grams, was filled with 525 grams of TNT and hexogen, and at an angle of 60 degrees could penetrate 130 mm armor. At an angle of 90 degrees, the penetration was 150 mm. After the impact of the cumulative jet, a hole of about 30 mm in diameter was formed in the armor, and the damaging effect inside the tank was quite significant. Though after the throw of the shaped charge grenade, which did not exceed the range of 20 meters, a soldier had to take cover immediately in a trench or behind an obstacle to protect himself from shrapnel and shockwave. In general, the PWM-1L was safer in its use than magnetic mines. In 1943, 204,000 hand anti-tank grenades were delivered to the troops. Most of them were used by the units on the Eastern Front. Experience of combat use showed that the shaped charge had enough effectiveness against armor of medium and heavy tanks. However, soldiers noted that the grenade was too long and inconvenient to use. A shortened PanzerWurfMine KZ, or PWMKZ, was soon launched, which had the same body as its predecessor PWM-1L. In the upgraded PWMKZ, the stabilizer design was changed. Stabilization was provided by a canvas band, which was pulled out of the handle during the throw. The grenade length was reduced from 530 mm to 330 mm, and weight was reduced by 400 grams. This was a major reduction in weight and size, and it improved throw distance by about 5 meters. In general, the PWMKZ was a fairly successful anti-tank grenade, guaranteeing the ability to penetrate the armor of all existing tanks at the time. This was confirmed by the fact that in the second half of 1943, the USSR quickly developed the RPG-6 anti-tank grenade based on the PWMKZ, which, like the PWMKZ, was used until the end of combat operations. That's all for today. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you all later!